An attorney in South County tobacco clerk avoiding News 4 today as things heat up. The store is accused of selling vape products to kids. Tonight, investigator Lauren Traeger learns a judge could rip the store's license away. It's a story you'll see only on 4.
This is happening. It makes me uncomfortable in school.
18-year-old Tommy Kelly says he's concerned about vape products ending up in the hands of kids. A News 4 investigation in February shed light on the issue. Some local stores selling vape without ever checking IDs. St. Louis County has cited Habibi Tobacco and Vape, located right across from Melville High School, 3 times for selling to kids.
You have an ID?
Earlier this year, a News 4 employee who is of age went in undercover and the clerk sold to him without checking for an ID.
Okay, just do me a favor and bring it in next time.
And then, after our investigation, police and the county health department did a compliance check on Habibi, this time using Tommy as an undercover officer.
Did he ever once check for your ID?
He did not check for my ID at all.
In court Thursday, Tommy testified before a judge who is now considering whether Habibi violated her own court order and should have their license to sell revoked.
Excuse me.
An attorney and store clerk from Habibi did not want to talk to us on camera, but in court, the clerk denied selling to Tommy.
Habibi is a store whose name comes up to us constantly. So it is really disappointing to hear that it continues.
Advocates against teenage drug addiction like Aaron Kelly say local stores need to be held accountable.
There's a lot of money to be made by selling to minors, and so it's worth it for the stores if they don't care about the fact that these products are going into the community to young kids. They're going to continue what they're doing until the consequences are much stronger.
This is the first time that the St. Louis County Health Department is seeking to revoke a tobacco license because a store sold vape to minors. A bill under consideration at the county council would strengthen the penalties for this. When the judge rules about Habibi, we'll let you know. I'm Lauren Traeger, News 4 Investigates.